Good evening, everybody. Hi, everyone. This is Dr. Hassan welcoming you and wishing you a very nice day. Today, here in this video, we are going to talk about the most common infectious disease in Malaysia and Indonesia, what is called dengue fever. My purpose from this episode is to create awareness for the majority of people here about this disease and how to deal with it. Dengue fever is an acute infectious disease that is characterized by headache, severe joint pain, and a rash that is caused by single-stranded RNA virus of the genus flavivirus, species dengue virus, transmitted by the mosquito of the genus Aedes, also called breakbone fever, dengue fever, or dengue fever. What are the causes of this disease? The viruses that causes dengue fever are spread by the mosquito of the species Aedes aegypti, and sometimes Aedes albopictus. Aedes mosquito are usually found in urban and suburban areas. They like to breed in man-made containers like tires, flower pots, and also household water. Aedes albopictus have been transmitted to North America and Europe by Asian product like used tires and lucky bamboo. Aedes mosquitoes can survive sub-freezing temperatures, which has allowed dengue to spread to cooler climates. Symptoms of dengue fever typically develop between 3 and 14 days after a person is bitten by infected mosquito. Classic symptoms include fever, headache, and pain behind the eyes, severe muscle and joint pain, extreme fatigue, and rash appearing between the second and fifth day of fever, tendency to bleed from the skin or nose, bloody stools or heavy menstrual bleeding, nausea and vomiting, respiratory symptoms such as a cough, sore throat, or nasal congestion. These symptoms usually last for 3 to 7 days, at which point the fever breaks. According to the World Health Organization guidelines, any of the following symptoms are warning signs that may signal the development of severe dengue, often called dengue hemorrhagic fever: abdominal pain or tenderness, persistent vomiting, lethargy, mucosal bleeding such as nosebleeds or bleeding gums, liver enlargement, fluid accumulation in the lungs or abdomen, as shown by X-ray or ultrasound. Dengue hemorrhagic fever is the most serious form of dengue fever. Dengue hemorrhagic fever is a clinical syndrome defined by the 4 key features: increased permeability of the blood vessels, leading to plasma leakage into the surrounding tissue, and lack of plasma into the bloodstream, which make the blood more concentrated. Low blood platelet count, fever that lasts for 2 to 7 days, tendency toward severe bleeding. Severe bleeding isn't the most dangerous form of dengue hemorrhagic fever. The most life-threatening concern is the leakage of the liquid part of the blood, plasma, into tissue surrounding the blood vessels. When this happens, not only can dangerous pocket of fluids accumulate where they don't belong, such as the lungs or abdomen, but there also isn't enough fluids left in the blood vessels to circulate the blood properly. This inability to circulate the blood properly is called shock. Shock is life-threatening and can lead to organ failure and metabolic problems. Treatment of shock requires hospitalization and intensive care unit for close monitoring and for the administration of medication that raises the blood pressure into a normal range. Doctors can diagnose dengue infections with a blood test to check for the virus or antibodies to it. If you become sick after traveling to a tropical area, let your doctors know. This will allow your doctors to evaluate the possibility that your symptoms were caused by a dengue infection. Treatment. As with most viruses, treatment options will only manage its symptoms. Pain relievers that don't make bleeding worse may be taken, such as acetaminophen, but aspirin and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs should be avoided due to its anticoagulant properties. Intravenous fluids may be given to help prevent shock, but frequent blood draws and other assessment must be performed to make sure that intravenous fluids aren't making the person sicker. Dengue fever vaccine. The first dengue vaccine, Dengavaxia, was made available in Mexico in December 2015. This live vaccine, which covers all four dengue subtypes, is given to people aged 9 to 45 as a three-dose series. Dengavaxia has been shown to prevent 59% of dengue cases. Thank you for watching our video. If you like this content, please do like, share, and subscribe my channel to stay updated the future videos. See you next. Bye bye.